Hey everybody, Luke 15 today as we continue through the New Testament. Luke 15 is one of the most amazing chapters in the whole Gospel of Luke. It's the picture of how much God loves you and I. And Jesus uses three examples to demonstrate that. And you're probably familiar with this chapter. You might have heard this, if not studied it yourself. Luke 15 is the story of the lost coin and the lost sheep and then the lost son. And he uses these three stories to make an exclamation point about how much the prodigal love of God, how much he loves you and I. He searches for you like a coin that's lost in the house. He's going to upend everything to find it. He loves you like a lost sheep, willing to go into your world and rescue you from the thicket and the thorns and all the stuff that we put in, go into and find in our lives. And then what makes us different than a sheep or a coin, he loves you like a lost son. You know the story of the prodigal. He wants the money from his daddy. Basically says, Dad, I wish you were dead. And I want my part of the inheritance. That's what he's saying. Dad, I wish you were dead so I could have my inheritance. And the dad complies and gives him his inheritance. He goes off, spends it all, loses it all, finds himself hungry, has to start working like the lowest level farmer servant, and still hungry, eating like pigs, eating the same stuff that pigs eat. Comes to his senses. What a picture that is. Comes to his senses. Like, what in the world am I doing? You ever had that moment with God? Comes to your senses. What am I doing? Why did I take this path? Why did I choose to do this sin? Why would I let myself get in this situation? Why would I reject God's ways and always pursue mine? That is what sin is. Sin is the pursuit of self. It's choosing to do what satisfies you or me instead of what satisfies the Lord. And holiness is the exact opposite. It's choosing to do what satisfies or honors the master. So if you know the story, the son starts his way back to just wanting to be a servant in his dad's house. If I'm going to serve somebody, if I'm going to be the lowest level, I might as well go to my dad's house where he at least took care of people. And not only does he return home, but he returns to a welcome. Not only does he get back to work for his dad, but then he discovers the prodigal love of his dad. Something a Jewish man would never do. He sees his dad run to him, throwing his arms around him, throwing a party for him. This was not the reaction he expected. And then Jesus makes this note that Luke records in verse 10 of chapter 15. Luke 15:10 says, I tell you, there is more rejoicing in the presence of angels of God over one sinner who repents. One sinner, someone who has gone their own way, who turns back. What he's describing there is like a two-step dance with God. You are just like the lost coin. You can't recover yourself. You need God to come find you. You're like the lost sheep. You and I, we're sinners who have wandered off on our own and have no way back without God coming to rescue us. But what's different about us than a sheep or a coin is you are also like the lost son, that you can make a choice. You can turn back. You can take a different way. You can take a step. When I was a kid in high school, they would teach dances as part of physical education. They would teach us to dance. I hated it. I don't like to dance. I always feel like I'm stepping on everybody else's feet. But the one dance I could learn was the two-step. It's one step and the person follows, another step and the person follows. As long as I made the right step, we could dance. Jesus is telling you and me that he's ready to do the dance with us. He's just looking for one step. One turn back, just one about face, and he's ready to receive us. That's the prodigal love, the outlandish love of God, is he loves us enough to take us back. And I wonder if maybe there's a two-step in your future. I wonder if there's a step you need to take to turn back to him. Maybe you're not like the prodigal distance away from God. Maybe you're close to him. But you need to turn one more step back to him in obedience, in love, in honor to him. He's ready to receive you and me. God bless you as you do. We'll finish up this week tomorrow.